Guatemala is an excellent destination for seeing things that you're unable to see anyplace else. Things like burning volcanoes, world-famous coffee straight from the slopes where it's produced and roasted, and remains of once great Mayan civilization. So let's take a look at the 10 best places to visit in Guatemala. Before we get further, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Alright, let's get to it. At number 10, Quetzaltenango. Quetzaltenango has been characterized as the ideal Guatemalan town despite its long name. And this is the country's second biggest city, although it's neither too enormous nor too little. Xela, the Mayan name for Quetzaltenango, although it's neither too enormous nor too little. After the Spanish left, Xela, the Mexican name for Quetzaltenango, is another name for the city. After the Spanish left, the Germans moved in, giving this old coffee-growing hub the same multicultural character as the Central Plaza, which houses the Cathedral Espiritu Santo. Hikes to Laguna Chicabal, the Doormat Volcano, and the active Santa Maria Volcano may be started from the city. At number 9, Antigua, Guatemala. The magnificent ancient colonial town of Antigua is one of Guatemala's main tourist destinations, set against the picturesque background of three majestic volcanoes in the country's central highlands. Antigua, formerly the noble capital of the Spanish Empire in Central America, was seriously devastated following a huge earthquake in 1773, losing sovereignty to what is now modern-day Guatemala City. However, nonetheless, Antigua has a remarkable collection of well-preserved Spanish buildings that lend the city an alluring and romantic feel. At number 8, Montero. For a little rest and leisure, many people go to white sand beaches. At Montero, a renowned beach resort on Guatemala's Pacific coast, you won't find those. Volcanic black ash makes up the beaches. If you plan on doing any beach combing, pack sandals because the sand might be extremely hot for bare feet. It boasts good surfing waves, but these sea turtles may be Montero's primary draw. Four kinds of sea turtles lay their eggs on the sand. At number 7, Livingston on the Caribbean coast. Along Guatemala's Caribbean coast, this little community of brilliantly painted wooden cottages hidden in a bush along coconut palms. Because of its Garifuna people, ancestors of fugitive would-be slaves and indigenous Maya, Livingston seems more like the Caribbean than the rest of the Guatemala. They developed their own culture and language. Caribbean rhythms abound, and they intensify in May as Garifuna pilgrimage comes into town. At number 6, Semucshampi. If you go to Semucshampi, you got a 30-minute ride through the forest on difficult roads, but the trek is worth it. Once there, you can unwind by swimming in magnificent turquoise blue pools. The Cajabon River, which produced the limestone bridge that currently runs beneath it, is also an incredible turquoise blue. There are caverns within the limestone bridge. Some caves are only accessible by diving underwater. At number 5, Chichicastenango Market. Isolated Chichicastenango, sometimes called Chichi by locals, is a huge town surrounded by valleys and mountains. On Thursdays and Sundays, the peaceful cobblestone lanes come alive with one of Guatemala's largest and busiest markets. This is the residence market, providing necessities, veggies, and the unique textiles for which it's famed. Vendors travel long distances for this market, making it ideal for people watching and photography. And number 4, Grutas de Lonquin. The Lonquin Caves, located northeast of Coban, are deep limestone caves featuring an underground river, lagoons, and unusual rock formation. A segment of the cave can be toured, which includes some rough paths and limited lighting. Thousands of bats live here and give an intriguing show as they exit the cave in a nightly mass migration to feed in the neighboring forest. If you want to experience this unique scene, plan to explore the cave in the late afternoon and then stay until the sunset. At number 3, Panajacho. It's a lakeside town in the southern central highlands, called after the indigenous term for the white sapote, a tropical fruit. The town is located on the beaches of Lake Atitlan, which dominates the scenery, with the Sierra Madre Mountains on the beaches on the opposite side. The picturesque landscape surrounding Lake Atitlan is a natural playground where tourists may engage in a variety of outdoor activities. Boat rides, swimming, and kayaking are available on the lake, while the neighboring mountains, farms, and hills provide chances for hiking, horseback riding, and watching, visiting coffee plantations, and viewing historical Mayan sites like San Baj and Chusnamit. And number 2, Museo Ixchel de Traje Indígena. Visit the Ixchel Museum of Mayan Clothes for an overview of traditional Guatemalan costumes, ranging from ceremonial items to everyday wear. The museum is located on the Universidad Francisco Marroquín campus. The large collection of textiles originated in the late 19th century and comes from 120 Guatemalan towns. displays are complemented with a collection of artworks depicting regional clothing. This museum is named after the Mayan goddess of fertility and weaving. At number 1, Tikal. Tikal, located in the Petén region of northern Guatemala, was one of the most important towns of the ancient Mayan civilization during its classic period, which lasted from 200 AD until 850 AD. Archaeologists believe Tikal's population peaked between 50,000 and 100,000 people. It was a religious, political, and a commercial hub due to its advantageous physical location, which was flanked on both the east and the west by rivers. Although it flourished during the classic period, some of the site's construction goes back to the 4th century BC. Tikal's kings were replaced at the time, yet the city thrived. Well guys, that's it for this one. What do you think about it? Let us know in the comments below. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe and ring that bell to get notified about our latest videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.